Hello, Dissenters. My name is Etalyx, and I am here today with an indie game called Igneous. It has been developed by four students at DigiPen, who you may have heard of before. They do make some very nice games. And it was developed over the course of 16 months, but it's available for free for you to play. And I've got links in the description of this video, so you can download it as soon as you're done watching this video and seeing what it is all about. As I mentioned, it is free, and as much as I love my free game spotlights, as you should know by now, free games are usually very short, and this one will take you, you know, if you learn how to play the game fairly quickly, less than 10 minutes probably to get from start to finish, but that doesn't mean it's any less fun or any less worth you downloading, but I'm going to be playing through probably the whole thing here for you to check it out. Now, what am I doing in this game? Well, I've got a tiki here, and I can control him with WASD, roll him around on the ground. That's going to be the primary thing that you're doing, is steering him and propelling him forward, and you can also have a jump with spacebar.
Yeah.
Yeah, he says.
You.
Okay. I love my tiki rolly ball here. Okay, so what we're going to do is head on down here and go into what amounts to the first stage. This is kind of tell you, okay, yes, this is how you move. This is going to be the primary gameplay mechanic. But look at the visual style, will you, for 2 seconds. For a game made by students, this is a very shiny game indeed. I love the aesthetic style, just lots of bright, glowy lights, and of course we're in a volcano! Didn't you realize that? Did I not mention that ahead of time? We're in like an erupting volcano, so it's going to be erupting all around us. There's a heavy use of physics, as you're seeing here. Lots and lots of detail going into this game. And it's just pretty much a straight-up adrenaline rush. We're trying to avoid an encroaching wall of lava while not falling into the lava pits ourselves, but I'm already failing at that, and I'm about to die at the very beginning of the level. Now, as you notice, when I take damage, the shield just turned back to blue. I have a little shield here that can take a few hits before I go down and die, and I assume have to restart the entire level. Look at all those fireballs flying in the distance. Tell me this does not look amazing. Tell me that you're not downloading it right now. I dare you. Now, there are actually two difficulty modes in this. There is normal, which I am playing for the purposes of this video, as well as an impossible mode. I have not actually tried impossible, and I don't know what differences it makes on the actual gameplay, so I can't really tell you how the difficulty scales in that regard. What you're going to notice here is that there are a lot of boxes flying at us. Those boxes are aiming to block our path, obviously making our travels here a lot more difficult. And there's also these floating rings that I'm kind of passing by here. I'm not sure what good those do or what those are for necessarily, but they're there. I don't know. I'm sorry. I'm so uninformed. I feel so stupid. No, but this game is really exciting. There's just action everywhere. And as I mentioned, it is just like pretty much just straight adrenaline rush. You're just constantly like, oh no, I'm gonna die, don't let me die. Oh, I thought I was done rolling, but apparently I am not. Going down this little hill here, and I believe the game has taken over for me. It's propelling me over this great chasm onto the other side, and presumably the next level. I believe there are 3 total real levels. And this is across the molten sea. It looks like some kind of crazy bridge here. Starting each one in the same fashion, rolling away from the encroaching wall of lava. Look at all those physics! This is a student-made game. And it's very impressive for what it is. Look at them just rolling past me. Lots of things in here to keep it all exciting. You are simply a rolling ball. And I have to applaud anyone who can make something so simple so exciting. Oh, I almost fell. I almost fell through the hole, through the crack. So yes, if you do fall, as I mentioned, I believe you will just start the level over. But that is, so it can be quite challenging, especially on the third stage from what I have seen. It will get more difficult. I want to try out the impossible mode now. Maybe I will do that after I'm done with this video. But overall, I want to give these guys great applause. I love spotlighting free games, but I love that even more than that, spotlighting games that are student developed. That is even better, because I love giving these guys, you know, just a little bit, a few more people to take a look and appreciate their game, hopefully. That was a pretty quick stage by comparison to the first one, but this third one is probably going to be the most difficult one yet. And I'm very excited. Oh, we got laser beams! We got these fire-breathing dudes. Just, man, this game, I can't believe that it has motion blur, it has so many physics, it's got so many special effects and glowiness going on. It's almost sensory overload, isn't it? Oh, I got hit by the lasers there. If I take like one or two more hits, I'm probably gonna die. I gotta dodge these lasers, and it seems like they're taking chunks out of the ground behind them as well, so I guess I need to be careful of that and have really good reflexes. Oh no! I took another hit. Oh, gotta dodge that laser. Oh, it's making my brain hurt just a little bit, because you have to have really fast reaction time, and sometimes, no, I have fallen to my depth. I lost all of my speed. All right, hopefully we get it on this try. We did lose once, but it's okay. We're gonna get it this time. I have faith. I think the key here on this level, obviously, the laser beams are the greatest threat to you. Not only do the laser beams actually hit you and knock off part of your shield like you just saw there. Oh, my goodness. I'm about to die. This takes a lot of concentration. But the lasers, especially on this bridge part here, seem to be taking out huge, you know, chunks of the ground out from underneath you, and it looks like it could be really easy to fall in the cracks if you're not careful. So it does require a lot of reaction time, yes, but this game also requires you to be both looking immediately in front of you so that you don't get laser beams like that. Oh no. Oh no. We gotta dodge. This is super focused time going in now. But what I was saying was, you also have to look very far ahead of you to make sure that you're not about to fall inside of one of the holes newly created by these laser beams. Altogether, I think this is a lot of fun and definitely worth you guys downloading right now. It's like 100, 150 megabytes, I believe. And there's sensory overload. Like, there's just so much going on screen, and I think that I have actually managed to beat the third level here. I have navigated the course with prowess after, you know, losing the first time. We're just gonna ignore that, it's okay. It looks like I am now shooting a Kamehameha through the teeth of that tiki onto the other tiki head. And I believe that will be game over. Again, this is Igneous by the students at DigiPen, known as Going Down in Flames. I encourage you guys to check it out with the links in the description of this video. If you like these type of videos, spotlighting these free games, especially games you've never heard of, these indie type games, you can let me know by leaving me a like and a comment below. I would appreciate it oh so very much. I want to thank you guys very much for watching. I appreciate all of your support, and I hope to see you again. My name is Etalyx, and I will see you next time.